Have you ever wondered what terms like watts, volts, and amps actually mean? Hey, it's Dan Zimmerman and welcome to Illustrate to Educate. In this short video, we'll break down what watts, volts, and amps are with super easy examples. Also, be sure to stay tuned to learn about the Flashfish T300 Pro portable power station. Electricity powers nearly everything around us, but most people aren't quite sure what terms like watts, volts, and amps actually mean. These units show up on everything from light bulbs to phone chargers, and understanding them can help us use power more efficiently and safely. At its simplest, volts measure the pressure of electricity, kind of like water pressure in a pipe. Amps measure the flow rate, or how much electricity is actually moving, and watts tell us the total power being used, which you get by multiplying volts and amps. For example, if your microwave draws 10 amps at 120 volts, it's using 1,200 watts. A typical LED light bulb might use just 10 watts, while a hairdryer can use around 1,500 watts. Then there's watt hours, or WH, which measures energy over time. If watts are like the speed of a car, watt hours are the distance it travels. So a 100-watt device, like a box fan on medium speed running for 1 hour, uses 100 watt hours. This helps us understand how long something can run on a battery. For example, a 300-watt-hour portable power station could run a 60-watt mini fridge for about 5 hours, which is calculated by doing 300 divided by 60, assuming no energy loss. This unit is especially important when sizing power stations for camping, emergencies, or even just charging multiple devices at once. This is where the Flashfish T300 Pro portable power station comes in. This power station packs a durable 230 watt-hour LiFePO4 battery that lasts over 3,500 cycles and charges fully in just over an hour. You get 9 types of outlets, including AC outlets like wall plugs, USB-C for fast charging phones or laptops, USB-A ports for standard charging and a car port like a cigarette lighter outlet, and DC ports. I tested out this power station by using as many of the outlets as possible, powering things like a projector, an iPad, headphones, Nintendo Switch, laptop, and a fan on high speed. It also has an adjustable LED light for added convenience in dark, off-grid situations. So if you're looking for a high-quality portable power station for camping, RV, or emergencies, be sure to check out the Flashfish T300 Pro portable power station by clicking on the link in the description. Once you start noticing volts, amps, watts, and watt hours in everyday devices, it all clicks. Your phone charger might be labeled as a 5 volts and 2 amps, multiply those, and it's delivering 10 watts. A laptop might use 60 watts, a TV around 100 to 200 watts, and an electric kettle can shoot up to 1,500 watts. Understanding these numbers helps you make smarter energy choices, whether you're trying to conserve power at home or figure out what your portable power station can handle. It's a simple layer of knowledge, but one that makes a big difference in how we interact with technology we use every day. Did you find this video about watts, volts, and amps to be helpful? If so, don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe to Illustrate to Educate to support more simple and objective videos on topics that matter. Also, be sure to click on the link in the description of the video to check out the Flashfish T300 Pro portable power station.